ChatGPT just underwent the biggest upgrade since the release of ChatGPT.
Wow!
I can't believe I'm saying this, but this is bigger than GPT-4. Because what just happened could be summarized by saying ChatGPT just released their very own app store by introducing ChatGPT plugins. Now we'll get into all the details here, but just know what you could do here is say, can you take care of my food over the next week? I want to go to a restaurant 2 times. And with a combination of all these plugins, ChatGPT could create a meal plan, book 2 restaurants, order all of the food from your meal plan to your home, calculate the calories, and do all of that based on the previous information that you uploaded that might include your food preferences. Yes, that's right. ChatGPT communicates with the internet now, and you'll be able to upload your own data so it doesn't have to guess what you like anymore. So let's have a look at all this one by one, because every single piece of info in here is mind-blowing. And with that, we should probably start with the biggest item, and that is that ChatGPT will offer internet access. Now, first, I should point out, all this is not available today. If I go into my ChatGPT, you don't see the plugins tab yet. I consulted a bunch of people. Nobody seems to have this yet. But from the examples in their blog post, you can see what this is going to look like. You're simply going to change your model to plugins, and then you can select multiple. But back to the internet access. So what happened here? Well, I'll tell you what did not happen. ChatGPT is still only trained with data up until September 2021. But that is the training. Now they can take that language model and plug it into the internet. And they decided to do this themselves, okay? So there's 2 plugins here that are going to be created by OpenAI. A lot of other third-party ones coming out, we'll talk about those soon, but this one, internet access, is created by OpenAI. Now, first of all, it makes quite clear that all the little plugins that did this up until now will become obsolete. Why would you download some unknown developer's app with 25 reviews on the Google Store if you have a dropdown within ChatGPT? And they even posted a mean demo video here. Look at that. So essentially, in the dropdown at the top, they changed the model to browsing. And now when she asks about this year's Oscar winners, after browsing the web for a few seconds, ChatGPT comes up with a curated result that comes straight from the web. And as opposed to what we got up until now, where it was more of a black box, like, here's your answer, we don't give you references, we don't tell you where this exactly comes from at all. Well, this takes it in the opposite direction. It shows you what we clicked on, it shows you what it read. And as you can see here, it has little references within the text, just like Google's Bard. And look at their speed of iteration. I mean, they released this 3 days after Bard started rolling out. It gives you up-to-date data straight from the internet. And the reason this works, although the training data is cut off in September 2021, is yes, they trained the model only up until then. But as you might know, if you went into the code, you could have trained ChatGPT with your very own data, which is going to be the next point here, by the way. And it worked, although it was not within the core data, right? So the way to think about this is the original training data taught ChatGPT how to think, how to reason, taught it how to answer questions and interact with humans. And from now on, they will allow you to take that large language model and add little parts to it. The second most exciting part of this announcement to me is the data sources they announced. You're going to be able to upload your own custom data and files to ChatGPT. They call this retrieval, and they already open source this plugin, so anybody can use this now if you're familiar with code, but it's only a question of time until we get a plugin here that is extremely user-friendly, which will allow you to plug your own data, your own website, your own database directly into ChatGPT. And just to be clear, if this is a spectrum, and all the way over here we had the situation that we lived with up until now, if you weren't a developer or a large organization, working with knowledge bases and the ChatGPT API was not really realistic for most people. Now, we haven't moved all the way to the other end of that spectrum yet, where it's simply going to be a dropdown and you upload your own file with a ChatGPT, but it's extremely close, because with the open sourcing of this retrieval feature, they kind of moved almost all the way over here. So essentially, if you want to explore your own documents and knowledge bases with ChatGPT, give it a few more weeks and it's going to be extremely easy. Okay, now let's talk about the example that I brought up in the beginning of combining these multiple apps, right?
And again, I want you to have a look at this demo. So what happens here essentially is they pick multiple plugins.
And I'll make this really simple to understand, okay? So Wolfram Alpha essentially has a lot of real-time data and is excellent at math. OpenTable allows you to book tables at restaurants. And Instacart allows you to shop at a supermarket from your home.
So after they click the 3 of these, in seconds it's ready, and you can answer a whole new world of requests with ChatGPT. Because it's not just ChatGPT, but also all the apps that come with it. So once he says he would like to go to a vegan restaurant on Saturday and cook on Sunday, ChatGPT comes up with, first of all, a restaurant recommendation with the table reservation just being 1 click away. Secondly, with a recipe where Wolfram Alpha comes up with all the details down to the calories. And finally, with 1 click, you can order all the groceries to your home because it's linked to Instacart.
Look at that. You can just click chickpea salad and it orders all the ingredients to your home, and you have the recipe above. Now, with my example, I went a little further, right? Me personally, I love food, but when I work and when I'm busy, sometimes it feels like more of a chore to think about what to do, go shopping, cook, prepare everything, right? If I know that I have some sprint ahead of me, like I do right now, every day right now, I spend about 4 hours recording course modules for the ChatGPT course that we're making here. And yes, I would absolutely love to tell ChatGPT, can you prepare me the food for the next 5 days? Make it healthy and easy to prepare. Doof. Creates a meal plan, gives me a link to buy it all, done. And as I pointed out before, if you add the data sources functions that they're also introducing here soon, you're gonna be able to include a document here with, this is a list of my top 10 favorite meals. And then the next time it creates the meal plan, it will adjust to your needs. That's just unbelievable. And to me, the funniest thing is, this kind of destroys most of the criticism that ChatGPT faced over the past few months. At least the part of the criticism where people were like, oh, but it gets things wrong a lot of the time, and it's not up to date, and it can't even do that much. I mean, fair enough, in some use cases that was true, but with this, not anymore. Two more things to talk about, and I'm keeping the biggest one for the end of this video. The code interpreter that they added, and most people will be like, ah, yes, okay, another coding thing sounds good. No. This is the one, another coding thing that you actually want. Because if I had to summarize coding in 3 seconds, I would say you solve problems by writing in a foreign language. And the problem with that for most people is that they don't speak the foreign language. And even if they get a file that does something that they want to do in that foreign language, well, making it work is kind of a pain. You need this standalone app called the interpreter, and then you need a bunch of plugins. You need to install the language. And when there's error messages, you need to solve them. Well, not anymore. As you might know, with ChatGPT, writing some of this simple code got quite simple and user-friendly. All you need to do is ask and copy paste, right? But making that code work was not simple. Well, that problem is disappearing too. With the code interpreter, you're going to be able to write code inside of ChatGPT and execute it inside of ChatGPT, and not just the basic stuff. Look at this simple demo where they switch it to code interpreter, upload an image, because GPT-4 will be able to do that soon, right? And then you can simply say, can you make it 4 times smaller? And ChatGPT can do it because it has a code interpreter now. Please tint it a little light green. Done. Now use OpenCV to select foreground only, and it cuts it out. Now, given you might not know what OpenCV is, but a beginner could have simply asked, how would I cut out the foreground? And it would simply tell you, you can use OpenCV. And in the end, can you make a download link for me? Sure. You click the download link, and we just saw Photoshop inside of ChatGPT. And on Greg Brockman's Twitter, he goes even further than this. He shows how you can use this to edit videos. So he uploads a video file to ChatGPT. Then he says, can you extract the first 5 seconds of the video? It generates the video and it does the operation for you. Can you believe this? Inside of ChatGPT, you're going to be able to cut up videos and convert them and so much more. You click a link, you download a new file. And when I mentioned earlier that two of the most important apps they kept to themselves, well, it's this one and the web browsing functionality, okay? And with all that being said, if you zoom out a little more, you realize that the implications of this are even larger than all the standalone apps that they presented here. They really just introduced the first big app store for AI applications. And people have been using this all over Twitter, and I think it works so well. It really compares to Apple with the iPhone and then the App Store, right? They first came out with a revolutionary product, which in this case is ChatGPT, and then they added on the App Store. Now you can expect a lot of the similar developments as with the App Store, right? First, they kind of test it out. Then as they already announced, it's going to be opened up to more and more people. And eventually people are going to be able to build their own apps and publish them on here. And because it's going to be so easy, because now you can use ChatGPT to write some of these plugins, I expect all the little utilities to trend towards zero. They're going to be 99 cents, $2.99. maybe $9.99 at best. And again, this is a little speculatory because they have not officially announced that they're opening this up to everybody. They're saying all of this is gradually rolling out over the next months, and they're releasing access to this plugin building platform to their partners and people on the waitlist step by step. The biggest limiting factor here is their consideration for safety, which is a good thing. But the one thing that makes me believe we're only gonna get more of these plugins every single week is this sentence. After discussing some safety implications, they say, we're also using these findings to inform our decisions to gradually deploy access to plugins. And if you combine that with the fact that in this paragraph on retrieval, where you're going to be able to add your own data, they open source the repository that allows you to do this yourself. And on launch of this plugin store, they already showed this little unverified badge. One can only assume what's going to be possible with a combination of ChatGPT and the internet. If you want a taste of what they're coming out with, just go to the blog article. I linked it in the description below. You can see the various plugins that are going to be available. For example, with Expedia, you're going to be able to book flights via ChatGPT. I'll just tell you this. I'll be on top of this every single day, and I'll be sharing groundbreaking information linked to ChatGPT as soon as it comes out. And not just that, I'll be showing you step by step how to get the best results from all this. So subscribe for more content like this, and check out this video to start expanding your ChatGPT skills today.